Hello everyone, my name is Kent and welcome back to my workshop. This is a Tormach TTS tool holder. It fits a special collet that draws the tool to the nose of the mill spindle, creating a reproducible tool length offset and eliminating the need to touch off after a tool change. By accurately measuring and storing the tool length to a lookup table, we can recall the tool length offset during a tool change. To measure tool length, a small surface plate is offered with a hole to receive the holder's shank. However, we can do better. Today we'll drill a TTS shank size hole into a decent sized surface plate. We'll then look at how to perform a tool length offset measurement and enter and use those values in LinuxCNC.
This is the surface plate that Tormach sells to measure tool length using a height gauge. Unfortunately, the size is so small that many height gauges will be poorly supported. A larger surface plate has many more uses than the specialized TTS surface plate, but larger surface plates don't normally have a hole drilled to receive the TTS tool shank. Today we'll drill that hole. To drill the hole, we'll use a 20mm diamond core drill, and this one has a 70mm depth capacity. Heat is a killer of tools, and the diamond core drill is no different. To reduce heat generation, we reduce the speed of the drill press to 200 RPM. The surface plate is heavy and the drill press must be capable of supporting the weight. Before starting, verify the drill is square in both axes with respect to the surface plate. This surface plate has ledges and I want to drill nearest the internal edge of the ledge to provide the greatest strength while minimizing the drilling depth. To help find the correct location, we use a template. To help cool the core drill, minimize dust, and provide some lubrication, water will be used. To retain the water, a barrier or plumber's putty is used. More water is better because water quickly becomes a slurry. Use only light pressure when drilling. The drilling will be slow, but going slow will increase the chance of success. I occasionally backed off the drill to help water reach the tip of the drill. At this point, it felt progress was no longer being made. The water, now a slurry, and the core drill were only slightly warm. Turns out the drilled core had snapped off and plugged the drill. Perhaps backing the drill off caused this to occur. Clearing the drill requires pushing the plug out, which is not necessarily easy. It may be better to drill some amount and then carefully break off and remove the core. If your core drill plugs, try to remove the drill without moving the surface plate to avoid needing to realign the hole with the core drill. It was very satisfying to see the slurry drain away. The total time to drill through the 45mm ledge was roughly 15 minutes. Next, we clean the surface plate and then we'll look at how to perform tool length measurements. We'll use a height gauge to measure the tool length after first zeroing the height gauge to the surface of the surface plate. However, the height gauge wheel has some amount of leverage and it's easy to lift the height gauge while zeroing. I like to verify that I've properly zeroed the height gauge by comparing to a gauge block. At 3 inches, the height gauge should clear the gauge block. At the smallest amount less, there should be interference between the height gauge and the gauge block. A similar strategy is used to measure the tool. First, bring the height gauge down to the tool to the smallest distance while still maintaining clearance. Measure in all points of the tool in case one is longer than the others. Then, to verify that measurement, any additional decrease should create an interference. By chance or design, this tool has a very convenient length. Since under normal conditions, tool length should not change, we can store links to a lookup table. This is the tool table in LinuxCNC. We add a new tool to our library, numbered 6, with a measured length of 2.500 inches and a diameter of 1.50 inches, or 38 millimeter, and a meaningful description. After entering the information, select Save File to save the tool table. Then select Reread to load the saved tool table and verify the new tool is present. And finally select Reload Table to update the in-memory tool table. The tool table is referenced by G-code when selecting and changing the tool and when doing tool height compensation. After selecting our height probe and loading its length offset, we touch off on the stock height. The probe's length was measured with the plunger depressed to the probe zero point. After finding the stock's height relative to the probe's length, we can switch tools to the facemill we just measured and not need to touch off again. The TTS tool holders use the spindle nose as a common reference datum. Ideally, the skimming cut at height 0.000 should not remove any material, but the raw extrusion will never be perfectly flat, and so perhaps a thou was removed from the high side. To further test the face mill, we can take a bit more material off. This required approximately 750 watt and thus the limit of the 1 horsepower spindle. And finally, we perform a slower finish pass. The face mill replaces a fly cutter to address concerns of safety and the long-term effects of an impossible to balance fly cutter. I'll still use a fly cutter, just less frequently. The face mill leaves a nice finish. I was pretty hesitant to drill my surface plate, but I didn't like the dedicated small TTS surface plate. It took a while to find a source for a deep enough diamond core drill. Other than plugging the core drill once, drilling the surface plate was uneventful on a drill press. Keep the drill cool with water, use a slow RPM, light pressure, and all should be fine. I would be reluctant to do this with a handheld drill, but perhaps it would work if using a guide, which could be as simple as a wooden block with a 20mm hole clamped to the surface plate. Thank you for watching. Your viewership is the fuel that keeps these videos coming. Please consider commenting and subscribing, and I hope you'll be back for the next video.